Okay. And now the first step is draw a set of coordinates. We should not draw the circle first, but for simplicity I am drawing that. So you assume that there is no circle right now. Okay, so draw a set of coordinates. So these coordinates are like sigma x1 here, is the circle skewed in your figure, like more onto when you see the diagram? Hello. What I meant is, like, is it a proper circle or
sir,
is it coming like an ellipse?
Like an ellipse. It's looking like an ellipse. It's not proper circle.
Oh. Okay. How is it now? Still the same, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
still
sir.
The same. But I can understand, sir. You can continue.
Okay. Okay. Actually, in my figure, it is coming like a circle. So assume that it's a circle only. It's not an ellipse. Okay. So we'll start with the coordinates, the sigma x and tau x1 y1. And this is a sign convention we are using. A positive shear is plotted downward and positive angle is plotted counterclockwise. So that's why we are making tau x1 y1 in the downward direction. We are assuming that that is positive. Now, we assume that there is a center. That center, let it be locate center. Okay, so what is the information given to us? We are given a strain element. It is having a sigma x. This is our strain element, sigma x, in the along. There is a shear stress. We are now defining sigma average as sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Okay. So I am locating the center in such a way that this point, this corresponds to sigma average comma 0. Okay. Now locate point A. So that point A corresponds this one. The point A corresponds to this face. I mean the stress element along this face. So this is point A. This is nothing but sigma x comma tau x. Now point B corresponds to the 90 degree inclination from the face of point A. So if I plot, that will come as sigma y, then tau x, it will be minus tau x. This we have discussed in the last class, like when theta equal to 0, it is sigma x and tau x, and when theta equal to 90 degree, it will be sigma y and minus tau x. So now, so we located the point A and B. So the point A corresponds to theta equal to 0 degree, point B corresponds to theta equal to 90 degree. Now I draw a line passing through the points A and B, and we can see that it passes through the point C. So this is the point C, the center. Now with C as center and either CA or CB as radius, draw a circle. So now you have to draw the circle. The circle I have drawn earlier, I mean in the initial part itself, but you have to draw the circle now. So now join A and B. So it passes through C. Now, next point is using CS and the with the radius equal to CA, draw a circle. So this is called, so this one, it is called the Mohr circle, and I will explain in detail like what does this each mean. I need to add some more points here. So this corresponds to tau xy, this corresponds to minus tau xy, then there is a point here, I call it as this is our coordinate system, the origin of this coordinate system O. Then let this point be P, and let this be Q. So what happens is, till this point it is sigma y. From here to here, it is sigma x. Now from O to C, we have, suppose if you don't know the value for sigma average, but I can show that sigma average is coming as sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Just OC will be nothing but, you can see here, this distance is nothing but sigma x minus sigma y. Okay. So now OC will be OP plus PC. And OP, we know it is sigma y. And PC is nothing but PQ by 2. Because these are like congruent triangles. And PQ by 2, PQ is sigma x minus sigma y by 2. PQ is this, the distance between this, sigma x minus sigma y. And finally, it will give us sigma x plus sigma y by 2. So always the center of the Mohr circle, you can find expression for the center of the Mohr circle from this expression, sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Now, what will be the radius? The radius of this Mohr, what will be the value for this radius? Can someone tell me? You can take the triangle AQC.
Sir, it will be R, sir.
Yeah, the radius is R. So what is the value for that?
Sir, root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 the whole square plus tau x by 2 the whole square.
Now, why it is tau x by 2?
Sir, it's only tau x y whole square plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. So it is nothing but this quantity CA, AC or CA. It is nothing but CQ square plus QA square. CQ is sigma x minus sigma y by 2, PQ by 2. And then QA is tau xy, this quantity. So we will get tau xy square sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square. Okay. Yes. This is fine now. So this corresponds, so this is a Mohr circle which corresponds to this train element, which is given like this, sigma x, sigma y, tau x. Now, we are interested in finding a stress on an inclined plane. So we have sigma x here sigma x, sigma y, there is a shear stress, tau xy. Now we are just considering another inclined plane, where we are considering this sigma x1 sigma y1, this is tau x1 y1, tau x1 y1, and this angle of inclination is theta. So how are we going to do that from the Mohr circle? So that is a question. So we have so we will start with this. We will first draw the Mohr circle for this quantity, like the strain element where everything is without inclination. So again, repeating the previous procedure. We have a center here. That center, let it be, we call it as C. This is the origin. So, okay. Now this corresponds to our A and B. So what is A and B? It corresponds to this face A, this is B, so it will be, okay, let it be like that.
Sir, shouldn't A and B lie on the x-axis, sir?
Why A and B lie on the x-axis?
Sir, because they are values corresponding to theta equal to 0 and theta equal to 90, sir.
A and B are points in the Mohr circle, but in the stress element, it corresponds to the face in which we are considering. It is not a point A is a point in the Mohr circle, but that point A corresponds to this face in the stress element. Similarly, point B corresponds to this face, the horizontal face in the stress element.
Actually, we got the Mohr circle based on the equations of sigma x1 and tau x1 y1 only, no, sir.
We got the Mohr circle. Yes.
Then there we took theta equal to 0 like for phase A and theta equal to 90 for phase B. Like that will only correspond to the...
Yeah, for theta equal to... No, for theta equal to 0, I will write here. For theta equal to 0, we got sigma x1 as... sigma x, tau x1 y1 as tau xy. So we just plotted in a circle where the coordinate systems are given by sigma x1 and tau x1, where sigma x is to the positive x direction, tau x1 y1 is in the vertical direction. And then we found that when theta equal to 90 degree, sigma x1 is sigma y, tau x1 y1 will be minus tau xy. So that's why we got a point which is in the this quantity will be sigma y and then minus tau of xy because yeah, minus tau of xy. So a point in the upper quadrant. Is that clear, or do we need?
Yes, sir. So, sir, we are taking the reference plane as the principal plane.
No, no. We didn't think it started with the principal plane till now. The plane which we are considering now is the.
No, sir. What I meant was we are taking principal plane as theta equal to zero plane, sir. That is no, how we construct the most, sir.
No, no. The principal plane is nothing but where there is maximum normal stress, and there is not maximum normal stress. We should say when there is the shear is zero. That is called the principal plane.
Okay, sir.
I will come to that principal plane now. Like once I define the transformation equations here. Okay, I need to erase this part. Okay. Okay, so okay, now it is correct. So this point A and point B corresponds to the previous figure, sigma x and tau xy, sigma y and minus tau xy. Now, as I said before, a angle 2 theta on Mohr circle corresponds to an angle theta on a stress element. Okay, so if you rotate the stress element by a theta degree, in the Mohr circle we should rotate it by 2 theta degree. So what does this mean? Here, this is the original stress element through which we have drawn the line AB. Now we are rotating this stress element by a theta degree. So similarly, this line AB has to be rotated by 2 theta degree. So this angle will be 2 theta. And we say that the points corresponds to this Mohr circle. So which will be like the points say A, B, C, D and E. This point corresponds to the face here in the inclined plane. Similarly, the point E corresponds to this face, sigma E. So this point B has coordinates sigma x1, tau x1, y1. Point E has coordinate sigma y1 minus tau x1, y1. Okay, let it be, no problem. Now, we'll just consider, I need some more, okay, this is, let it be P. Q, yes, the final point let it be T. Now what else we need? Okay. So this sigma x1 we can find it as, sigma x1 corresponds to the point S. So it is nothing but OS. Okay. So do you understood, like, if anyone has any doubt regarding what is ED now? Okay, I will explain one more time. This line AB has two points, A and B, which corresponds to these faces, A and the horizontal face, B. Now we are saying, we are making an inclined plane at an angle theta with respect to the horizontal axis, and we need to find the stresses along that inclined plane, as well as for that inclined element. A theta inclination in the stress element corresponds to 2 theta rotation that is in an anticlockwise direction in the Mohr circle. So the points where this line intersect, we are rotating AB by 2 theta degree anticlockwise in this figure. The point where it intersects the circle, the point D and D corresponds to, the point D corresponds to this face. and point E corresponds to the perpendicular face of this one. So the point D has the coordinate stresses as sigma x1 and tau x1 y1, which we can plot it here, which we can consider here. This point D has sigma x1 and tau x1 y1 as the stresses acting along that plane. And we, in the previous class, we have derived an expressions for sigma x1 and tau x1 y1 in terms of the sigma x, sigma y, tau xy and theta. We are trying to bring the same equations using a graphical representation right now. So sigma x1 will be the length from point A and point S, that is OS, and it is given by OS can be written as OC plus CS.
So how this become 2 theta?
Yeah, it has become 2 theta, yes, this one, 2 theta.
Sir, how? It is rotated by angle theta, no?
Yes, that's what we are doing. If we are rotating by theta on a stress element, in the Mohr circle, we are giving a 2 theta rotation. That's the assumption we are making.
Okay, sir. That's assumption.
Yes. And also, the counterclockwise rotation is taken as positive. And positive shear stress is plotted downward. These are the three assumptions which we are making.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so what can you say about the sigma x1 value now? Okay, I will OC, O to C, in the previous slide we have written this one, this expression, sigma x plus sigma y by 2. So OC is sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus. Now we need to see what is CS here. CS, okay, I am putting another notation. This is, let it be beta. So CS will be CD cos beta, right? CD is nothing but the radius of the circle. So it is R cos beta. Okay. Now what can you say about tau x1 y1? Tau x1 y1 will be this line, that is SD. It is nothing but R sine beta. So up to this point, everyone understood, right? You can stop me, like if you have doubts. I think that's a okay. I can proceed. Okay. So now the thing is, like, you need the final target is you need to get the expression sigma x1 tau x1 in terms of this equations A and B. So in equation A, you got this expression sigma x plus sigma y by 2. So this is, it's there now. So you need to make a substitution for this cos beta and sine beta. For that purpose, okay. So for that purpose, we are considering this combined angle 2 theta plus b. Okay, we will write. Cos 2 theta plus b. Previous figure, cos 2 theta plus b will be what? CQ by CA. And what is CQ now? What will be CQ? Can someone give an answer? Okay, I will plot that in the
sigma x1, sir.
CQ will be not. Yeah.
The CQ is sigma x plus sigma y by 2. PQ by 2.
Once again, can you repeat? CQ is?
So CQ is sigma x plus sigma y by 2.
No. CQ is not sigma x plus y by 2 because.
So CQ will be sigma average minus sigma x.
Yes. It's coming like that. Because from O to C, it is sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Then from C to.
Yes, sir. It's sigma x minus sigma y by 2.
Yes. So this quantity we have defined like before, PQ by 2 and PQ, we got the sigma x minus sigma y by 2. Sorry, sigma x minus sigma y. This quantity, sigma x minus sigma y, PQ. Okay. So CQ will be, yes, PQ is nothing but sigma x minus sigma y. So CQ will be the half of that, sigma x minus sigma y by 2. Sigma x minus sigma y by 2, the whole divided by CA. CA is nothing but the radius. So I'm just putting R. Okay, so similarly, I'm just put sine 2 theta plus b also will be considered. Sine 2 theta will be nothing but sine 2 theta will be aq by hypotenuse ac, and aq is nothing but, okay, I should write the coordinates for yes, this is sigma x tau xy point A. So tau xy by r. So what are we? What we are trying to do here is we just use the trigonometric formula here. Cos a plus b is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Okay. Cos 2 theta cos beta minus sin 2 theta sin beta. Here it will be sin a cos b plus cos a sin b, sin 2 theta plus beta, sin 2 theta cos beta plus cos 2 theta sin beta. So let it be this equation be 1, let this equation be 2. Now we multiply this first equation with cos 2 theta. Then it will be added with the second equation multiplied by sin 2 theta. And finally we will get an expression for cos beta. Cos beta is nothing but 1 by r sigma x minus sigma y by 2. Cos 2 theta plus tau xy sin 2 theta. And similarly, we need an expression for sin beta also. So that will be first equation multiplied by sin 2 theta minus second equation multiplied by cos 2 theta. We will get this equation. Sin beta equal to 1 by r. Now we use these equations, substitute it here, sigma x1 and tau x1, this cos beta and sin beta we are replacing now. So what will you get now? So sigma x1 will be, from the previous equation it was sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus r cos beta. Sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus r cos beta. R cos beta is this term, this quantity, the one inside the bracket. So that is sigma x minus sigma y by 2 cos 2 theta plus tau xy sin 2 theta. So this is our transformation equations which we have derived in our previous classes, which means that from the Mohr circle, the point A, D corresponds to the coordinate sigma x1, tau x1, y1, and this is actually nothing but given by this expression, which is the stresses across an inclined plane. And similarly, tau x1, y1 is r sine beta. Which is nothing but the one inside this bracket, sigma x minus sigma y by 2 sin 2 theta plus tau xy cos 2 theta. Okay. Okay. Now, we need to find the principal stress and plane. Okay, so what is the principal stress now? Or where does this principal stress occurs? Or
sir, on the x-axis. That's on the shear stress zero.
Yes. So what is the reason? Because on the principal stress, we know that the sigma x will be maximum and tau xy will be the minimum. I mean zero, not minimum. Sigma x is maximized and tau y will be zero. So when you draw,
sir,
yeah,
sir, sigma x will also be minimum only, sir. Minimum also will come around, no, sir.
Yes, true. Sigma, there is for a maximum there is a minimum. Two values are there. Yeah, thanks for correcting that. So the principal stress, principal plane is defined in the way like there is a shear stress is zero. So when you consider this Mohr circle, you can see that shear stress is zero on this line, on the sigma x1 direction. I will plot it now. So this is our sigma x1, this is our tau x1, y1. So we are saying this tau x1, y1, we are assuming it is zero. So it will be on this line. So these two points corresponds to our sigma 1 and sigma 2. This is our C, point C, this is our origin. So what can you say about sigma 1 now, the value for sigma 1? It will be OC plus the radius, right? OC plus the radius. And sigma 2 will be OC minus radius. So OC is nothing but sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus radius is sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau xy square. And similarly, sigma 2, there is a, instead of plus sign, it will be minus sign. So what can you say about the angle that we said about, like theta p1, theta p2 are the two angles in which this principal plane lies? How can you locate these angles that we will discuss now? So we'll go back to the original figure. We had this point A and B. No, not point A and B. Let it be point A and B. Suppose theta, so this line OC, maybe I call it as, okay. So when you rotate Okay, this will be measured as the 2 theta 1, theta p 1. One second. So this angle is 2 theta p1. Now cos 2 theta p1 will be, what can you say about cos 2 theta p1? Let this point be A, B, C, D. So it will be CD by AC, and CD is nothing but, what can you say about CD? CD is
sigma x minus sigma y by 2.
Sigma x minus sigma y by 2. Maybe I should use the notation Q only, because so that it matches with the previous. Let it be Q. So CQ. Sigma x minus sigma y by 2 by the radius r. And similarly, you can find sine 2 theta p1, that will be tau xy by r, and from this expression you will get tan 2 theta p1, that is nothing but tau xy by sigma x minus sigma y by 2. This we have obtained when we discussed about finding the principal stress by taking the derivative of d by dx of sigma x1 equal to 0. When we did this operation, we obtained this type of equation, which now we are getting through the Mohr circle. And then we also said, like, there are two angles. One angle corresponds to the maximum value, let it be theta p1, and other value corresponds to theta p2, the minimum value. So how can we obtain that concept here? So from the line AB, if we give a 2 theta p1 rotation, we are getting into the first principal plane, the principal plane corresponding to the maximum value sigma 1. From this, if we rotate one more, like with a 180 degree, we will get sigma 2. So that is, which means that 2 theta p2 is nothing but 180 plus theta p 2 theta p1, and theta p2 will be 90 plus theta p1. So this difference between theta p1 and theta p2 is 90 degree. They are acting on perpendicular planes. And then, okay, I need to add one more slide here. Similarly, we have to locate the maximum shear stress. Locate maximum shear stress. What will be the maximum value of the shear stress now? Or where will be the point? Yeah, some answers.
So radius of circle.
Radius of a circle, but where it will be the point?
Sir, it was mentioned as theta s.
Can you repeat it? I couldn't hear it properly.
Sir, the maximum shear stress was obtained as obtained at 2 theta s.
Okay, that's okay. But
sir, perpendicular to AB, sir.
The maximum shear perpendicular to point C.
Okay, parallel to the y-axis.
Parallel to y-axis, passing through the point C, right?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Because the maximum value of the shear stress is either this value or this value, and this act at these two points. Okay, so this is the tau max value. This is minus tau max, or this is plus tau max. And what will be the value for the term x? It is nothing but the radius of the circle. And the radius of the circle is given by square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau xy whole square. And we know that this acts as there will be a line. What will be that theta angle for which the maximum shear stress occurs? Okay, we know that two theta p1. Okay, I will draw a figure again. This is the center. So this is our 2 theta p1. 2 theta p1. This is the maximum tau max minus, and this is the plus tau max. So the maximum value occurs at this point, which means that the we need to extra like add 90 degree with respect to 2 theta p1, or we need to add 90 degree with 2 theta p1, and we will get the maximum angle at which, sorry, the angle at which the maximum shear stress occurs. So, and we define that angle is theta s. So in Mohr circle, it will be nothing but 2 theta s is nothing but 90 plus 2 theta p1. So theta s is 45 plus theta p1. And we have discussed that the theta s and theta p1 differs by 45 degrees. Okay. Yes. Similarly, we can find it for theta p2 also. Theta p2 will be 90 plus theta p1, which suggests you need to add one. Okay, I will write here. 2 theta s2 will be 90 plus 2 theta p2. So now we have a numerical example. This one we have solved using the transformation equation in the previous class. Now we will solve the same problem through the Mohr circle. I will call a name. Anish Raj. Sorry, Anish Rai. Are you here? Let me know. Anish Rai, are you here now? So, okay, Anish Rai is not here. Next person, Abhishek, roll number 3.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we have to solve this problem. State of stress at a point in a machine component is given by the stress tensor. Compute the normal stress and shear stress on a plane. Okay, before going to that, we'll start with the basic steps from the introduction part of this question. Okay. So let me know what to draw now. What is the value for sigma x, sigma y, and tau xy?
So 120.
Which one? Sigma x is?
Sigma x.
120 MVA? Yeah.
And then so 24 the sigma y?
24 sigma y. Okay.
Yes, sir. And the shear stress is like the
and tau xy
is 30.
Okay.
So
yeah. So how are we going to proceed this problem now?
So sir, first of all, we will draw like sigma x along the x axis. Sigma x, we can also change the unit, like we can do 10 centimeter, like 10 megapascal equals to 1 centimeter. So sigma x will be 12 centimeter. For easy, like easy per.
No, I didn't get you. What you are saying?
Like sir, we can also write the 10 megapascal. Let the 10 megapascal equals to 1 centimeter for easy purpose.
1 for centimeter.
Like sir, for unit conversion, finally we will do again.
No, no. Like you just fix to this MVA only. You don't need to change to any other. Yeah.
So sigma is 120. That is.
Okay, just see the one. You just need to tell me the answers only. That will be the easy way. I will draw the Mohr circle now.
Okay.
What? Let it be the C center. So what will be the center value?
So center value will be wait, sir. AB. It is 120 plus 20.
It is sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Right.
Yes, 50. Yes. Not sir, 120. Yes, sir. It's 70.
70.
Yes, sir.
So this point corresponds to 70, 0.
Okay, sir.
So we'll draw the stress element also now. The stress element will look like this is 120 MPa. Okay, one second. Sorry. This is 20 MPa. This is 30 MPa. Similarly, we have another one more. Okay. Now, this is our line which corresponds to this stress element, this condition, which were provided in the problem. So, what will be the value for this? This point.
So, this point is below 30 mm from x axis. 30 megapascal. 30, it is sir, 30 in y direction.
No, the x coordinate will be what value?
X coordinate, sir. Wait.
X coordinate is this one, sigma x, comma sigma tau xy.
Okay, sir.
So this is 120, 20. Sorry, 120, 30. The reason why I didn't draw a vertical axis till now because we don't know where the origin lies, whether it lies inside the circle or whether it lies outside the circle. So we need to find that part initially. So OC, it is coming as sigma x plus sigma y by 2 is 70 MPa. And what is the radius here now? Radius expression, it is given by sigma x minus sigma y by 2 square plus tau xy. So what will be the value for it?
This is 100 square minus 2500 plus 900 0 0 0 0
0 0 0 0 0 0 0
0 0 0
No, no, please repeat it. Like, please check your calculation again.
Okay, sir.
It is coming as 58.31. Right.
So 10 to 34, I say. Yeah, that's 58.3.
58.3, right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we can see that from this point to this point, it will be 58.31. Okay, I will mark this point as maybe P, P, okay, and this point let PQ. So QC, it is nothing but QC or PC, QC and PC. And from origin to OC is 70 MPa. So I have the confusion whether where should I plot O, whether O should be put it here or O should be put it here. But clearly the radius is given by 58.31. So we can see that the point O, the origin point, should be outside this small circle. So now we are drawing this one. So this is our tau x1 y1 and this is our O. So this is clear, right? Okay. Now I will call another name. Aniket Singh Tomar, roll number 13. It's not here. Amit Vikram, roll number 11.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible to me, loud and clear. So we got these points, OC, and then we got this point, 120, 30. So what what will be this point now?
So which point?
Okay, let it be M.
So which point?
The point M.
So since we know that C is the midpoint of MN, and we know that sigma x is 120, the x coordinate of N, M should be. If we consider that x coordinate of M is x, then x is equal to x plus 120 by 2 is 70. It means x is 20 megapascals. The x coordinate is 20.
X coordinate is 20 because this point is sigma y minus tau xy.
Yeah, yes.
Sigma y is nothing but 20 and 20 minus 30.
Minus 30.
Okay. Now the question. Okay, till this part is fine. Now the question we are asked to find is, compute the normal stress and shear stress on a plane whose outward normal makes an angle theta degree with respect to x-axis. So on this Mohr's circle, so this line MN corresponds to this type of a stress element.
Okay, sir.
Now your question is, you are making a rotation, 30 degree rotation with
respect to x. If the rotation is made by 30 degree, then on the Mohr circle, the line MN will get rotated by 60 degree.
Rotated by 60 degree, yes. So before rotating that, you should know what is this angle.
Okay, sir.
So what
that angle? That angle, if we consider it as theta, then tan theta is equal to tau xy upon... But if first you have to label that point, perpendicular point, it's the theta is q over, it's sigma x minus sigma y over 2r, which means 120 minus 20 upon 2 means 50 by r. Radius is 58.38. Wait, I'm calculating. It's cos inverse. Cos inverse.
So I thought this as alpha. 50. So what will be sin alpha now?
So that angle is coming out to be 30.94 degrees.
30.96, I think. Okay. Yeah, 94. Okay. 30.9. So how did you calculate that?
Sir, I have calculated that using the formula that cos 2 theta p1 is equal to sigma x minus sigma y upon 2r. Yeah, sigma x is 1.
One second, theta p1 is the for the principal stress.
Oh, sorry.
Even that formula is valid here also, but still you should not use you should not use the notation p there, because that corresponds to the principal stress. You should say either you take instead of taking tan alpha, you can take the sine alpha, and sine alpha will be this quantity. Tau xy?
Yes, sir. Tau xy upon r.
Tau xy upon r.
Which is 30 upon 58.3. Which means sine inverse of 30 over 58.3. it's equal to, so 30.96
degrees.
30.96 degrees,
yes.
Yes, sir.
And in this, you, as you said, you are giving a rotation of 60 degree, 2 times 30 degree.
Yes, sir.
So you are rotating Mn by 60 degree. So let it be this line.
Yes, so sir. This angle will be 29.04.
Yes. So this total will be 2 times theta degree, where theta is nothing but the 30 degree.
Okay.
So this angle, beta will be now how much?
60 minus 30.96, which is 29.04 degrees.
29.04.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now the question is, you need to find the sigma. You need to find the question. Yeah, the question is, you need to find the normal stress and shear stress on this plane. On this plane. So let this plane be called as ST. So the normal stress and shear stress will be given by this coordinates of this point T and S. So how do you find the coordinates of this point now? So this will be sigma.
Sir, we can know that since we know that CT is equal to radius, which is 58.3, and we know that the angle beta is 29.04. We can find the x coordinate of that by using OC plus that r cos beta.
Exactly, yes.
So sigma x1 is OC, which is radius. No, it's not radius, it's the distance. Sigma x plus sigma y by 2 means 70 plus r cos beta. R is 58.3 into cos
29.04. Yes, how
Looks
much are you? Yeah. To everyone, I want to repeat here, the coordinates of this point T corresponds to the stress elements along the inclined plane at theta degree, like 30 degree. So the coordinates, the x coordinate of this point T will be sigma x1, and it is given by OC plus this portion from C to this coordinate point. And this line, it is nothing but r cos beta. And similarly, tau x1 y1, this will be the length of this line, so this line segment, that will be r sine beta.
Sir, it's coming out to be 120.97 megapascals.
Okay.
And second one is the y coordinate, which is tau x1 y1. It is 28.2999. It means 28.3
megapascals. 28.3 megapascal. Okay. And one second. Okay. Yeah. 28.3. You are correct. But at the same time, it is coming in the upward quadrant. So it should be a minus
value. It should be negative. Okay, sir.
So when you report it here, it is a negative value.
Okay, sir.
Then what will be the sigma y1 now?
So sigma y1, which is the diametrically opposite point of that, and we again know the midpoint of sigma x1 and sigma y1, which is the 70, 0. So we can use the midpoint formula for that, which is 140, which is 140 minus wait, 140 minus sigma x1. 120.97, which is
19.03. So just how much you are getting? 19.03.
Yeah,
it is, yes, correct. So sigma y1, you can find it like OC minus R cos beta. Okay.
Yes, sir. That's the other way. The OC is 70 minus R cos 29.04. So that's also the same answer.
Yeah, that will give you the same answer. And you can check, yes, that sigma x1 plus sigma y1 is nothing but sigma x plus sigma y.
Yes, sir. 120.97 plus 19.03 is coming out to be exactly equal to 140, which is 120 plus 20.
Yeah. So now Yuvraj, are you here? Yuvraj, not here. Dindraj Saini, roll number 31. Ganesh Aravind, 35. Shruti Kirtana, 39. Are you here? Oh, only 32 people are there now. Okay, I should call from this name. Ram Prashad.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm there.
Yep, okay. So, can you compute the principal stress and principal planes on which they act?
Yes, sir. Sir. One second.
So just tell me the location of the principal stress.
So principal plane.
Or the value for the, like in this Mohr circle, what will be the value for the principal stress?
Sir, 1 by 2 sine inverse 3 by root 34.
What is that? I'm just asking. Principal stress is sigma 1 or sigma 2 and in this Mohr circle, in this circle, like where is the principal stress now?
You are asking me the principal axis.
Yeah, principal axis as well as principal stress.
Okay, sir. So principal axis you actually denoted by alpha.
Okay, alpha. Yeah.
So with that we can actually calculate sine alpha will be 30 by 10 root 34.
Okay.
So with that we can find alpha, like location of the principal axis with respect to the x-axis.
Okay. But where is what will be the value for the principal stress here? Or which point in the Mohr circle corresponds to the principal stress? I am asking you, like, along the principal stress, the maximum shear, along the principal plane, the shear stress will be zero.
Yes, sir.
So, in this small circle, which point corresponds to that condition? The shear stress is zero.
Sir, the exact point, image of point n over x-axis.
But that image of n over x-axis, that point is not lying on the circle, right?
Yes, sir.
We need a point on the circle where the shear stress is zero. Which will be that point?
Then point P, sir.
Point P, okay. So, according to our definition, principal planes are those planes where the shear stress is zero and the stress corresponding to the normal stress corresponding to the principal plane is called principal stress. So what can, so the coordinates of this point P, the x coordinate there is a one value, the y coordinate will be zero. So what can you say about the x coordinate of the point P? Will it be the principal stress?
Yes, sir, because at the point P shear stress is zero.
Okay. And similarly, similar to point P, we have a one more point Q that corresponds to the minor principal stress. Okay, so now, okay, leave it. Now the question is, what will be the value for the major principal stress, or what will be the coordinate at this point P? So I call it as sigma 1 comma 0. So I need to know what will be the value for sigma 1 now. Sigma 1, you can say like either OQ plus QC plus CP or something like that. You just tell me some line segments.
So then we can say that OC plus PC, sir.
Okay. Or, OC plus PC.
Yes, sir. So OC, we know that 70.
Yes.
So that plus PC.
And what is the value for PC?
So PC will be also radius, sir. PC is radius.
Yeah. So what will be the final answer? You have computed OC here. There is a radius also here. So what will be the value?
Then summation of that will be the answer.
So can you just tell me the value now?
Yes, sir. One second. Sir, can you show me previously?
Yeah. Just 70 plus 58. That's all.
Yes, sir.
And what will be sigma 2 now?
Sigma 2 will be OC, OC minus R.
Okay.
It will be 70 minus 58.31.
Yeah. And now, can you tell me what will be the angle theta P1 here?
Yes, sir.
What will be the angle? Actually, you have mentioned that before.
Sir, 1 by 2 sine inverse of 3 by root 34. I can calculate and tell, sir. One second.
Okay. No, that's fine. But tell me, how did you get that?
Sir, in the triangle ONP, in the triangle ON, and you didn't mention that point, sir. In that point, we can find sine alpha will be, sine alpha will be 30 by 10 root 34.
Okay.
So, yeah. But alpha in the Mohr circle will be half of, twice of the principal angle.
Yes. Yeah. So MN corresponds to like the principal plane is nothing but the line OP, and it is at an angle of alpha degree with respect to the line segment MN.
Yes, sir.
So 2 theta P1 will be nothing but alpha here.
Yes, sir.
So theta P1 will be alpha by 2.
Yes, sir.
And alpha we have calculated before, 30.96.
Yes, sir.
And what can you say about 2 theta theta P2? Theta P, so sigma 1, it is lying at an angle of alpha from MN. Now sigma 2 will be lying at an angle of, say, this is 180 degree now. So 2 theta P2 is nothing but 180 plus alpha.
Alpha.
So theta P2 is 90 plus alpha. Okay. Did you have any other class from 130 onwards? Hello?
No, sir.
Sir, but...
I just take two more minutes. I just want to have this maximum shear stress. So this maximum shear stress... from this figure, where will be the point for the maximum shear stress? I have mentioned before, like the maximum shear stress actually will be at these two points, right? And the maximum shear stress will have the value for as the radius. And the radius we have calculated as 58.31 MPa. And how did you calculate the theta is here?
So 45 plus alpha.
Yeah, that is 45 plus alpha, that is fine. But from the Mohr circle, how do we get that?
90 plus alpha.
Yes, this is the so, 90 plus alpha.
So 2 theta will be pi by 2 plus 2 alpha, then with that we can find.
Yes, so from here, this is a 90 degree. So this is a plane across which the maximum shear stress happening. So the angle will be 90 plus alpha. And from that you can calculate what is theta s. And that is coming as something like 60.48. So this will be theta s1. And if you add 180 degree again to this point, so 90 plus 180, so total 270 you add now, you will get the theta s2 also. So 2 theta s2, this is theta s1, is nothing but 270 plus alpha. From that you can find theta s2. Okay, so these are the two examples. This will be slight, this is simple, like similar to the previous example. And this is another example where you have to know that one is tension and one is compression, and it is slightly different. I want you to try this problem and just let me know if you have any complications. I will share yesterday's class and today's class in a together file. So why there is low attendance now? Can someone tell me the answer for that? Only 31 people. I think 64 have registered, right? Class rep, are you here?
Yes, sir. Actually, it's today only the attendance is low, sir.
Why, you didn't have any classes sir, in the morning?
Sir, present is 13 are there, sir.
Oh, okay.
Totally 44.
But still 45.
It's a 45.
So and you have some this attendance policy, right? 75% attendance you must need, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So what will happen if you don't have this attendance? Will you be able to write the exam or you can provide some medical certificate and do that? Like how much you will be getting as a medical allowance for attendance?
I think it is 10%.
10%.
Maximum 10.
So 10% means if you are having a 50 classes, then it will be only 5 classes. Something like that. Okay, you try to attend the classes. At the same time, just be cautious about this attendance policy also, because since we are having everything online, we are having the electronic records, every attendance sheet, everything is, so we cannot make any further change once we give this, because every day we are marking your attendance in the book, we are making it as a hard copy, so finally when you come, okay, you don't have attendance, then we cannot do anything at that time. So just be cautious about that. So we will wind up today. And these two questions I want you to try, especially the last question. The second question is almost similar to the one which we have discussed today. The last one I want you everyone to try. You may get some doubts, but still. It's a simple one only, just apply this formula. I will give an assignment this weekend itself. And we are finishing the module 1, almost finishing. We will have one more class mostly on the last topic. Okay, we'll wind up now. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.